This is Gaylord again. This time I thought I'd show you how to do Keith Urban's Put You in a Song. Now, what you want to do on this is a really easy song to do. Just about three or four chords. The key is getting the licks in here right. Now, I'm going to show you how to do it if you're playing a song on your own, you're doing a gig by yourself, okay? So this isn't exactly the way he plays it, but I'm going to show you how to throw a few little extra riffs in there and make your guitar sound full while you're doing this. Now, the first thing that we're doing different from what he does, when he starts off that riff, he's actually doing a slide like this. And if you want to do that, that's fine. No problem with it, but it might be a little bit easier for you when you're doing singing a song on your own. Just do it like this. And you're using these fingers. You've got that D chord formation. So you've already got your D, so you're on the third fret, second string, and then it goes to the fourth fret, second string. And I'm going to use my pinky for that. Now that's the third fret on the second string for that note. And I've already got my ring finger on that string because of the D chord. I hit that note, I'm coming up like that. I'm picking up and I'm catching that second string with my pick. Now all you're doing there is you're sliding up to the 5/7 ninth fret with that D chord again, and you're doing the same thing. To the verse, he goes right to a G. Now, and again, in the song, he's just kind of, you know, doing this. But if you're playing a gig by yourself, you need those chords. So you want a G chord here. But you want a full G chord, not a campfire G chord. What I'm talking about there is you want to use your pinky finger, third fret on the first string, and your ring finger, third fret on the second string. And then you'll do your regular G index on the, use your index finger, second fret on the fifth, and your middle finger, third fret on your sixth. Hear how cool that's a G. That's a full G. That's a campfire G right there. Full G. Okay, so we're gonna go down and hit that. And when you start that verse, it goes into that G chord. Okay, so it goes. And I'm not gonna sing this. I can't sing this at all. But I'm just gonna try and show you how this starts off. Use your thumb and bring that up on the second fret of the sixth string and give that F sharp bass to it. So it's. Now that's a B minor. Okay, now I'm doing a bar chord B minor. So that's going over all the second frets, all strings on the second fret. And my middle finger is the third fret on the second string. My pinky is the fourth fret on the third. And my ring finger is fourth fret on the fifth. Now, here's what I'm going to do different on that. That B minor. Do a little bit of a rundown. Or walk down on that B minor chord to go back to a G. And all I'm doing is I'm starting on the third fret, second string, second fret, second string, and then open. Like that. And then it goes. Okay, so all you're doing is now fourth fret on the third string, fourth fret, second fret, open. Same thing on the fourth and fifth. Fourth fret, second fret, open, and now the fifth string, fourth, second, open. When you're playing it quick, you got that B minor, G, now what I'm doing there, just to give it some extra riffs, while I'm hitting that D, anything in there that's going to give you some fillers. Put you in a melody goes it's a that's an E minor chord and but I'm that's a full E minor, not a campfire E minor. So I'm keeping both these fingers again on that third fret, first and second string, and I'm using my index finger to cover the second frets on the fifth and the fourth. Third string is open, and that's the sound you're gonna get. Put you in a melody. That's an A chord, okay? All I'm doing on that is I'm using my index finger to go across the third, I'm sorry, the fourth, third, and the second string, and I'm hitting the fifth string open, like that, okay? So let's try that one more time. I'll call these chords out to you. It starts off in a G. That's all you got through the whole song, okay? I messed up a couple of those, I don't know the song that well, I guess. But anyway, you know all the chords. I'm sure you sing it a whole lot better than I can or play it. But anyway, that's all there is to it. So just remember, you when you're hitting those chords, just put a few extra riffs in there, and your guitar will sound full, and you'll be pretty impressive. So, hey, this is Gaylord. If you like my stuff, would you click on that like finger, what is it? It goes like that, I guess, huh? Give me a couple of likes if you want to be a friend or sub to me, and send this on to other people. I sure like to share, and I like to see those hits. So, hey, this is Gaylord. Hope that helps you a little bit. See you later. God bless you. Bye-bye.